So here I am, suddenly the king of the school. I never meant for things to turn out this way. I just wanted to control a couple of psycho kids and be left alone. But now I guess I'm certainly going to live the good life.
Hey, Darby!
Hey, Johnny.
Hi, Jimmy.
Yo, what's up, brother?
Hey, Jack.
So I'm like, yo, it's Jimmy!
Hey, you're funny, man.
Yo,
you're
man, so what's funny, going on? Jimmy.
Oh, hey, girl, you're looking great.
Ooh.
Great, thank you for that show, darling.
Wow, hey, Jimmy!
All right, boys, that's all I got to say. Later.
So
later,
Jimmy. Jimmy.
See you later. I love that guy.
Bye,
come on, let's roll.
Pete! Hey, Jimmy, what's going on?
Everything. I did it, man. I took over this dump. These morons are my morons.
That's
now.
Great. Just don't turn into a jerk.
How could I? Hey, baby. How you doing? What you doing later?
Just remember, Jimmy, not everybody likes you.
Correct. They love me.
Well, what about Gary?
Gary? Forget about that twerp. Dude, it's me now. I run this place and you're my friend, so please try to be cool. Oh, man, you're bringing me down. Come on, let's go milk this thing for all it's worth. We might even find you a girl.
Mr. Galloway, should you really be doing that?
Oh, Jimmy. No, I suppose not, but life is unfair.
You promised Ms. Phillips.
Oh, God. What kind of world do we live in where I get punished for a minor indiscretion and Hattrick gets away with taking bribes from his pupils?
He does?
Yes. He sells advanced copies of tests to the sons of his rich friends, and nobody says a word.
Wait, what rich friends?
Well, Darby Harrington, for one.
I can't believe he's selling tests. What if I got evidence of him doing this?
Then I'd never need to drink again.
All right, let me see what I can do.
Let me get some of that action.
You guys looking for something?
All right, I'll pay.
I sure hope he shows up. I need to get my grade up.
Don't worry, he'll be here soon, I'm sure.
Greetings. Did you chaps bring the money?
Yeah. Do you have the tests?
There you are, sir.
Of course. I trust you have my fee. See you in class. You know, he drinks on school grounds. Think of the children, Dr. Krabblesnitch.
Drinking? I will terminate the employment contract of any staff member found corrupting children. Morality is the most important lesson we can teach the youth.
Is that so? Then you might want to look at these.
What's this?
It's that fat, evil hypocrite selling test answers to rich kids. Fire him.
What? You took pictures? And to think I trusted you, Hattrick? You're fired.
But I...
Bye-bye, fatty.
And as for you, Galloway, there better not be anything to that drinking business.
That is funny, Jimmy.
No, it's not. Jimmy, it's really funny.
Chill out, man.
Jimmy, I need to talk to you about something.
Not now, Pete. I'm basking in adulation. I mean, running the school fairly.
Dude, so fairly.
No, Jimmy, please.
Pete, enough.
Yeah, shut up, Pete.
The court must know their king.
You know what, Jimmy? Forget the school. The whole town should know about you. You're like the mayor.
You should leave your mark on City Hall.
Yeah, dude. Take a dump on the doorstep.
No, you homunculus. Not a dump. It's something much more elegant. Paint a warning.
Yeah, that's a good idea. I'll show everyone who's boss.
That's right, Jimmy.
All right, you girls wait here. This is gonna be something they'll never forget.
Wait, Jimmy, don't forget about Gary. Wait for me.
This wave of vandalism has to stop! This is unacceptable!
So what are you doing out of the classroom?
That's
that's great. Listen, we've got a problem.
I'm the king, Petey, the king!
Whatever, you're a king with a load of problems.
I've only been gone a couple hours, what could have happened?
All kinds of things. You remember that promise you made about restoring law and order and improving the school? Let's just say it ain't exactly coming true.
Well, if anyone wants a fight, I'm right here.
I think Gary must be behind it, but trust me, everyone wants a fight. Listen, I gotta go. I'll talk to you later.
Oh, man.
This is a disgrace!
It's appalling! I don't want to play! You're a pet rat!
This is your fault, Jimmy!
Huh? What? No, it isn't. What are you guys talking about?
The library is full of rats! And I got my pre-med test next week, amigo! You're such a lame-o!
Some king you turned out to be!
Oh, how I long for the old days! Sure, we were laughed at and mercilessly bullied by everyone, but at least you could study without fear of rodents coming near us!
Get off! Oh, did you piss yourself again, Algy?
Ew!
No, oh, I swear!
Algy.
I spilled soda on myself.
Soda? Oh. Right. What a bunch of sissies. Well, I'm not afraid of a few rats. Jeez, pathetic.
Check the delivery crate to see if any of them are still lurking in there.
These crates?
Yes, those crates. The rats appeared once those books were delivered.
Everything seems to be fine, miss. I think I got them all.
Thank you, Jimmy. If you have any late fees, I think we can just forget about them.
I did that a long time ago. I mean, thank you, miss.
I don't believe this! Oh, no!
How did it happen?
Hopkins, come here, boy! Wait. What's up? My gym is up in flames! Look!
Damn, how'd that happen?
As if you don't know! You're a degenerate to think I trusted you!
It wasn't me. Yeah, I'm no saint, but I tried to bring order to the school, to stop the bullying.
Ha! Bullying? I don't care about bullying! In fact, I encourage bullying!
That's right!
Builds moral fiber, makes men!
Yeah!
Cause you didn't make the team, you had to ruin it for everyone.
Yeah, you bully!
You're a pig! You ruined my life!
What are you talking about? I never wanted to be on the team. You like to torment weak kids, and you've got the personality of a jockstrap.
Yeah, well, I called the police. You'll be killed for this, my boy.
It wasn't me.
You're done for, Hopkins.
Help.
What? Who was that?
It's Yuri. Oh, there's people trapped inside.
Oh, I'm really scared. Mommy!
Man, you guys are pathetic. I'll get him. Where's the fire extinguisher?
By the stairs next to the locker room. But don't think I've forgiven you, Hopkins.
Jimmy, thank you!
What happened, Mandy?
I don't know, but I saw some weirdo downstairs.
I'll check it out. You get out of here.
Be careful, Jimmy!
Do it!
Out of my way, schoolboy! I regret nothing!
It's not my fault!
Well, where'd he go then, you tramp?
Who you calling a tramp?
Hey, what's going on?
Johnny's disappeared, gone crazy, abducted by aliens!
I bet it was you, Hopkins!
Yeah. Since you turned up, everything's gone really weird.
King of the school!
Who's the daddy-o now, huh? My love has gone! Find him, king!
Quit poking me! You're both acting crazy. Cut it out. Now tell me, where's Johnny?
I don't know. Nobody's seen him. He got a little brokenhearted after we split up, but... it's not my fault.
Someone said they saw a couple of asylum orderlies driving up to his house. But you know how people love to talk. Johnny wasn't crazy.
Asylum orderlies?
He was a real leader. Not like you, Jimmy.
Look, I'll get your boy back, all right? See you later, freaks.
Thanks for getting me out, Jimmy.
How'd you get in there to begin with?
Some of the local kids said they'd gotten together with Lola. I went a little crazy.
I can believe that.
Yeah, anyways, I gotta find Lola, see if it's true or not. See ya!
All right, Johnny.
It's a pretty cool game. It's all about killing things and taking their stuff.
What was it called? Grottos and Gremlins or something like that?
Yeah. Hey, what are you doing in here?
I'm here to beat you up and evict you.
Enough talking, let's fight!
Let's.
See what Jimmy's got, Gordon.
Thank you.
What are you looking at?
Nothing. Oh, come on. I don't want to fight you. My name's Jimmy.
Zoe. I was at Bullworth once. I got kicked out.
Why?
Let's just say Mr. Burton is a dirty creep.
Seriously? I would love to teach that guy a lesson. He bullies everyone.
You know, he goes jogging every day and regularly uses the porta-potties in the park.
Yuck.
Yeah, so if we could catch him in one on top of a hill, then Mr. Burton could have a really interesting time in it.
Yeah, but they're all chained together. We'll need to get some bolt cutters.
Go get some from the Spaz Industries building and meet me at the park. Make sure no one sees you.
This is awful! Yuck! God damn, I stink! I'm gonna have to shower for days with bleach! Ah! This is worse than when I got hazed!
Oh, here he is, Mr. Big.
Yeah, it was you, creep.
What was me?
Don't play innocent with us! I tried that when Father caught me with Nanny. He gave me a good thrashing, and I've got half a mind to give you one.
Hey, look, just get to the point.
Someone stole our boxing trophies, buddy. They were heirlooms.
Well, it wasn't me, rich boy, so relax.
Well, if it wasn't you, then who was it?
I bet it was those greaseballs. I know it. They've always hated us. And so much for peace in our time, Popper. Just great.
Let's get them. Yes, it's time to teach those poor, disrespectful scum a lesson.
Wait, relax. Maybe it wasn't them. Maybe it was someone else.
Nobody hates us, apart from them.
Oh yeah, they do. Everyone hates you. You're all awful.
Oh, la-dee-da. Now he tells us. You are pathetic, Hopkins. You're not a leader. Out of my way. Come on, men. Let's go.
Okay.
It's war.
Hold on. Wait here. I'll go get your trophy back from those grease balls. Oh, man.
All right, Vance. Did you guys steal the Preppy's trophies?
No way, man. After the townie's been saying all that stuff about Lola and made Johnny crazy, we don't care about those stuck-up jerks.
The townies? Really?
Yeah, and Johnny says you're no friend of ours anymore. But since you got him out, I'll let you walk away from this meeting.
Well, since I already beat you, I guess I believe you.
Hey. All the little nerds running around screaming like girls. Can't be late for the party at the docks. All right, come on.
I should have watched TV instead.
Well, Pauper, what did you find?
Yeah, who took our trophies?
Don't tell me. It was the Tooth Fairy.
Yeah, either it was the Tooth Fairy or the Greaseballs. I wonder which one.
Actually, trust fund babies. It was neither. It was those townies.
Which townies?
The ones who hang out by the factory.
Them? Why would they steal our trophies? Don't talk crap, Hopkins.
I'm not. I've got a picture to prove it.
Why? They don't have any problems with us.
Yeah, poor kids just love rich kids who act like stuck-up jerks, don't they? Listen, you overfortunate numbskull. They did everything. Put Johnny Vincent in the home, let the rats out of the library, everything, including your trophies.
Why?
Because I listened to Gary.
So it is your fault.
No, it was Gary's fault.
You, my friend, have got delusions of grandeur. Nobody cares about you or Gary. You're ridiculous. Come on, Biff. Let's leave this king of the school to his pathetic little fantasies.
You are an idiot, Hopkins.
I've got a photograph.
You know what you can do with that, don't you?
Ah, Hopkins. Now, I'm not one to give in to popular sentiment.
You can tell that by your clothes.
What?
I'm saying you dress great.
Irrelevant. As I said, I am not a people pleaser, but in your case, I'm going to make an exception.
An exception? Cool.
Yes, you are without a doubt the least popular boy in the school right now. Even that fat child who wets himself is more popular than you. Coincidentally, it has also come to my attention that you are a filthy, dirty, foul-mouthed, awful little vandal.
Yeah, well, we already knew that.
Very droll. A comedian till the end. Well, you'll have to pursue your comedic talents elsewhere, boy. Bullworth is not for you.
I'm not the one who's funny. You know what's funny? You. You're a joke, you old creep. You and your stuck-up, lame-ass school with its bullies and sex-pest teachers. This place is a dump, and you're a big-nosed freak. This school rewards losers and bullies. I just stand up to them.
You painted obscene graffiti on the town hall, boy. I have it on good authority. It was you.
Oh, yeah? Then who squealed? Tell me that.
A commendable pupil did feel the need to tell me you were responsible for this outrage.
Gary Smith! Look, I may have painted a few jokes on the town hall, but that kid likes to torture people.
Gary Smith is the next head of this school. He's responsible, courteous, and not afraid of being an unpopular leader.
You are blind, old man. Blind!
And you are leaving. I tried to contact your mother, but she's still off on a cruise. Until I hear from her, I will have to let you stay here in your room. But you may not wear the school uniform or attend classes.
You gotta be kidding
me. You are leaving the academy to attend to your education elsewhere. Now get out!
Whatever, man.
Hey, Jimmy. How you doing?
Terrible. Everybody hates me.
Everybody might hate you, but everybody laughs at me.
Yeah, that's true. Those kids are jerks anyway, but I tried.
I know!
I mean, I tried to do the right thing, make people happy, stop all the fighting, make everyone calm down. Now everyone laughs at me. People used to be scared of me, and now I'm a joke.
It was Gary. It must have been.
I know. I can't deal with the fact that that kid beat me.
Well, it ain't over yet. God, one minor setback and you're acting like a baby. You're pathetic.
I've been expelled. They're just waiting for my mother to come back from her 58th honeymoon, then I'm out of here. How was that a minor setback?
Losers!
Oh, shut up, you fat dork.
Whatever. You and your has-been friend don't scare me.
See? Even a dork like that laughs at me.
We gotta prove Gary was behind everything.
We don't even know if it was Gary. All we know is townie kids beat up a bunch of Bullworth kids. I mean, I don't even care anymore.
Well, we've gotta find out what's going on. Come on!
Okay, but if we're gonna take on those townies, we're gonna need a bunch of backup. Someone big who doesn't hate me yet.
Russell.
Hey, Russell! I need your help to bust into the dropout's hideout.
Only if Russell gets to destroy.
Jimmy.
Yeah, okay.
What the hell are you doing here?
Looking for you, Zoe. I think I'm in love.
Don't be ridiculous. Haven't you heard?
Heard what, my love?
The school has broken out into a massive fight. Every gang and faction is fighting each other.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, man, I gotta go. How am I gonna deal with this? I'm gonna need some serious backup. Where's Russell? Where's your buddy Edgar?
Russell has been holed up in the Wonder Meat slaughterhouse, hiding from the cops. He's worried about going to prison after stealing that bike.
Russell can comprehend prison? Wow. Look, I'll see you later.
Well, what about love?
It'll have to wait, Zoe. Duty calls.
Captain said if I get one...
was that little runt.
Thanks, Jimmy.
Come on, we gotta get to the school. All hell's breaking loose.
Hey, Jim, this is your turf. What the hell's going on? The whole place has gone mental.
Yeah, it's your old friend Gary. He's the one causing all the trouble. The kid's a complete psycho, and now he's got the teachers and prefects on his side.
So?
So, we run in there, try to stop the fighting, and find a way to deal with Gary.
All right, one question. How are we gonna stop a load of kids from beating the crap out of each other?
It's America. We go in there with threats and bribes until we get what we want. If all else fails, we beat the crap out of everyone. That's why I brought along backup.
Russell likes to hurt people for peace.
Cool.
Then it's a plan. Damn! They're locked!
Don't worry. Russell will get it. That kinda hurt.
Edgar, we'll take out the gang leaders. Without them, Gary's got nothing. Ernest, you nerd! What were you thinking?
You fool! You don't see it! Gary's got a plan! A great plan!
You idiot! Gary's plans are a load of crap! I should know!
You don't get it! My brains and his lack of morals, nothing can stop us!
Whatever! I'm gonna stop you both!
Someone's here to see you.
Oh, it's the thug. Don't worry, boys. I'll deal with him.
You're getting really tiresome, Darby.
This is a bat.
Ted, I need you to help me.
Get lost, Jimmy. You ain't nothing.
You're just asking for it.
You want the more pump?
Get out of my face!
This is awesome.
What the hell are you doing, Johnny? Why are you taking orders from Gary?
Shut up, Jimmy! You left us and everything went down the toilet!
I beat you once, I'll beat you again.
Finish, you bunch of bitches!
That was incredibly satisfying! Edgar, go help everyone calm down. I've got some business with Gary.
Understood. Good luck.
You, what is that in your hand? Weapons are for prefects only.
No! Get off my little body! Slow down so Russell can smash you!
Aw, come on.
Your attention, please. Jimmy is complete human trash.
Gary, you little bitch! Come out!
James, I've been waiting. Let the games begin.
Gary!
Moron!
Why'd you do it, Gary?
Why not? I won! I tricked everyone! Starting with you, the head, the loser kids in town, and the prefects! Me! I won!
You are sad, man!
I might be sad, but I run your world, moron! And don't you forget it! You did all my dirty work for me, Hopkins! You're like a puppet, only dumber! If you prove to be one thing this year, it's slow!
You'll never catch me, Hopkins!
The thing is, if I win, you're just another punk! You win, and you'll be sent away even quicker for beating up the head boy!
Why'd you do it, Gary?
Because I can! Because making little people like you and the morons who run this place eat out of the palm of my hand feels great!
But I never did anything to you!
You would've if I'd given you the chance! Face it, I'm smarter than you!
Oh, congratulations! You're smarter than me! You hate everyone and everyone hates you! Genius!
The head likes me! I tied him up, turned his dumb school into a battleground, got kids expelled, unfairly, put several others into therapy, and he still likes me!
You're such a loser!
Well, at least my mom doesn't make her living on her back!
You're dead!
I can take you, Hopkins! Any regrets, Jimmy?
Back off, idiot!
I heard the whole thing! You're expelled! Come and untie me, boy!
Yes, sir! Sorry, didn't see you there.
You know, I think I may have judged you too unfairly, boy. Yes, a little rough around the edges, but you're a diamond, boy. A diamond.
Thank you, sir.
Now take out the trash, would you, Hopkins?
My pleasure.
So it was you who took on this monstrous little wretch, was it?
Yep.
What a hero! A lone wolf!
Uh-huh. Well, no. To be honest, sir, I did have a lot of help from some friends. Like this girl, Zoe. She got expelled because she complained about Mr. Burton hitting on her.
Burton? Well, he's fired! I hope he rots in hell!
And a guy named Peter Kowalski, good friend of mine.
Never heard of him.
Yeah, well, he keeps quiet. He's kind of shy.
Shy? The boy must be a genius. Why, he should be head of the school.
Pete? Great idea. Now, about that letter to my mother...
What letter?
Finally, everything is sorted out, more or less. I mean, I don't want to say we're going to live happily ever after or anything like that, but life is certainly going to get easier.
It's still on, and we're going. Cyrus sent an emissary this afternoon to make sure. Now, Cyrus don't want anybody packed, and he don't want anybody flexing any muscle. So I gave him my word that the warriors would uphold the truce. Now, everybody says that Cyrus is the one and only. I think we better go have a look for ourselves.
We're going in there with nothing. We're going in there like everyone else. Nine guys, no weapon.
You got the stuff? I want you to hit everything in sight. I want everyone to know that the warriors were there.
You never know what you run into out there. We're wearing our colors, you can't hide.
So who wants to hide?
Maybe we'll get to waste a few heads along the way.
You just soldier and keep your mouth shut.
When we get there, you stick close by, okay?
Don't worry, I don't feel like getting wrecked.
One thing we might get out of Cyrus's little get-together, meeting some strange wolf. I wouldn't mind nailing a little something down on the way back.
You got a one-track brain, you know that?
What's the matter, you going faggot?
What do you know about Cyrus?
Magic. Whole lot of magic.
What do you know about Cyrus? He's the one and only.
When you're president of the biggest gang in the city, you don't have to take any shit.
Fuck him. I'll tell you something. I'll bet nobody's even gonna be there.